In today's session, we will be dealing about amplifier-power relationship, a very, very important topic. So, in amplifier-power relationship, we will first see how an amplifier performs, and then we will draw the signal flow graph of an amplifier for an RF amplifier, and then we will derive various conditions like incident power, input power, available power, power available at load, etc., etc. There are so many parameters. So we will get it started. So the first thing that we are going to see is we will draw the amplifier conditions. Now I have an RF amplifier, which is a two-port device, and on the left side I provide it with a signal. The amplifier is fed with the signal, and on the right hand side I connect it to load. So ZS represents the impedance of the signal generator and ZL will represent the impedance of the load. Now a signal, VS is the voltage of the signal, and it comes out of the signal generator. B1 dash represents the output of the signal generator. It enters into the RF amplifier at A1. It enters into the amplifier, it may get amplified, and the output is available at B2. Not all the signal will enter into the amplifier. Some of the signal will get reflected as B1. Some of the signal gets reflected as B1. Similarly, when the amplified output is available at B2 and all the signal enters into the load, some of the signal will get reflected back. The reflected signal is represented as A2. The reflected signal is represented as A2. Now, this fellow, if you look from this side, this represents your source input, reflection coefficient, and this fellow represents your input reflection coefficient. Similarly, if you look at this side, from this side, this will be your gamma out, and this will be your gamma L. So these are the reflection coefficients. So it's a very straightforward definition. We have a signal that is being coming out of the signal generator at this point B1 dash, and that signal is entering into the RF amplifier at A1 as A1, and not all the signal will enter into the amplifier. Some of the signal will get reflected back. The amplified output is available at B2, which is connected to the load, and some of the signal will get reflected back at the load, which I have it as A2. Now let's draw the signal flow graph for this RF amplifier. Now BS represents the source. From where you have a signal generator and the signal is coming here. And B1 dash is the output of your signal generator. And this signal enters into the RF amplifier. A1. This is your A1. Now, a portion of the signal will get reflected back. All the signal will enter into the amplifier. Some of the signal will get reflected back. That is represented as gamma in, which is nothing but your input reflection coefficient. B1 by A1 will be nothing but your gamma in, your input reflection coefficient. Now, the signal enters into the amplifier here. Some of the signal will get amplified, and that is represented as S21. The gain of the amplifier is S21. So the output is available at B2, and B2 is connected to the load. And as I said, some of the signal will also get reflected back. And the ratio B2 by A2 will be your output reflection coefficient. A portion of the signal may also enter into the second port of the amplifier, which is your S12 or your insertion loss. S12 will be your insertion loss, and this fellow will be your source reflection coefficient. Let me tell you the signal flow graph again. I have a source, there is a signal voltage that is generated here, and it comes. B1 dash is the output of the signal generator. The output of the signal generator enters into the amplifier. Not all the signal will enter into the amplifier, so some of the signal, not all the signal enters into the amplifier, some of the signal also gets reflected back. So this reflection coefficient B1 by A1 will be nothing but your input reflection coefficient. What happens to the signal? It will go like this. So let's stop it here. Now this signal, this is the amount of signal that is entering into the amplifier. The signal gets amplified. So S21 is nothing but your gain. What do you call it? Let me write it straightforward. Let me call it as the gain of your amplifier. And V2 is the output of our amplified output, and that is provided to the signal generator. That is provided to the load. Now a portion of the signal at the load, it's not perfectly matched. Some of the signal may also get reflected back. So that is the reflected signal. This is just the reflected signal, and the ratio B2 by A2 will be nothing but your output reflection coefficient. And some of the signal may also get into the amplifier, trying to make the amplifier unstable. So that signal is called as S12, it is also called as isolation loss. It's also called as isolation loss. So the signal will enter, it goes like this, and it enters into the signal generator. So this is your signal flow graph of your RF amplifier. Now let us estimate the various parameters of the RF amplifier. So let's start off with the first parameter. The first parameter is called incident power. Incident power. P incident is the output of the signal generator. So what is it? You know, V1 dash is the RMS voltage. V1 dash is the RMS voltage. This is the RMS or this is the power available at the output of the signal generator. Since V1 dash is the RMS voltage, what will be P incident? P incident is equal to half V1 dash squared. Half V1 dash squared. Because V1 dash is your RMS voltage. Now let us derive what is B1 dash by BS. B1 dash by the transfer function B1 dash by BS. To compute B1 dash, let's get the transfer function B1 dash by BS. So if you look at this, I have a thing. This is your BS. This is your B1 dash. And look at this. I have a loop attached to it. The loop is like this. This will be your, what do you call it as, gamma in or S11, and this is your gamma S. This is your gamma S. So let's use Mason's rule to find out B1 dash by BS. What does Mason's rule say? Sigma PK del K by 1. I'm sorry, del. Sigma PK by del K by del. What is PK? BK is nothing but your forward path. How many forward paths you have? I have only one forward path. There is no gain attached to the forward path. So naturally this will be 1. So P1 is 1. This is the gain of your forward path. And what is del 1? Del 1 is nothing but a closed loop which is not touching the forward top. The gain of the closed loop which is not touching the forward path. There is only one closed loop but it is touching the forward path. So del 1 is also equal to 1. Del 1 is also equal to 1. So what is del? Del is equal to 1 minus gain of the individual loop. What is the gain of the individual loop? Gamma in into gamma S. Gamma in into gamma S. So if I write B1 dash by BS, it is equal to 1 by 1 minus gamma in gamma S. If you substitute it in this formula, you will have B1 dash by BS is equal to gamma in by. So let's go, if you call this as 1, if you substitute this value in 1, what do I have? I'll have P incident to be equal to, what is P incident equal to? Half B1 dash squared is nothing but BS squared, modulus of BS squared. This will go, we will substitute in terms of BS. B1 dash is nothing but BS squared by 1 minus gamma in gamma S squared. 1 minus gamma in gamma S squared. So this is your incident power. This is your incident power. So the next fellow which we will be computing is the input power. See, incident power is the power that is available at the output of the signal generator. As I told you, all the power will be entering into the amplifier. Some of the power will also get reflected back. So, incident power will not be equal to input power. So, now let's compute what is the input power. Let's hold it this for a moment. So the next fellow which we are going to compute is P input, which is nothing but input power. As I tell you, all the signal will not be entering into the amplifier. So P input will be nothing but incident power into 1 minus gamma in squared. 1 minus gamma in squared. If you can recollect, if you go back to your S parameters, we would have seen, shown this, it will be nothing but 1 minus S11 squared. So, it is nothing but gamma in. S11 is nothing but gamma in. So, P input is nothing but P incident into 1 minus gamma in squared. This fellow tells you that not all the power is entering into the signal, some of the power also gets reflected back. So, if you substitute P incident here, I will have P incident is equal to half P squared. You can refer this in the S parameters problems. We would have solved this. 1 minus gamma in gamma S squared. 1 minus gamma in gamma S squared. So, let's write it like this, modulus of 1 minus gamma in gamma squared. So, this is your input power to the amplifier. Oh, I'm sorry. I have another term here. I just forgot. 1 minus gamma in squared. 1 minus gamma squared. This is the input power to the amplifier. Alright. So, the next fellow that we will be talking about is power available at the amplifier, the power available at amplifier, what we call it as PA, it is noted, denoted by PA. All right. So, this is the input power, the power that is trying to enter into the amplifier. But when will all the power enter into the amplifier? What is the condition for maximum gain? The condition for maximum gain is that, or the condition for maximum power transfer is that Zin should be equal to, Zs star, I'll write it like this, yeah, Zin is equal to Zs star, or Zs is equal to Zin star, also gamma S is equal to gamma in star, either way it's the same. See, for example, I have, this is because, say I have R plus Jx, this is the, you know, impedance of the line, this is the impedance of the line, and this is the impedance of your amplifier, R minus Jx. So this is your complex conjugate, this is your complex conjugate, both these fellows are in series, both these fellows are in series. So what happens, minus Jx and plus Jx will cancel, so only R exists. So R exists. So in this condition, when Zs is equal to, this is Zs and this is Zn, I'm sorry, Zn star. In this condition, that is when R plus Jx is equal, Zs is equal to Zn star, the complex conjugates will cancel and only the real part exists, which means maximum power will get transferred from the cable to the amplifier. Maximum power will get transferred from the cable to the amplifier. So this is the condition for maximum power transfer. Zs is equal to Zn star. So, condition for maximum power transfer. So if you look at the condition, if you substitute this condition here, what do I get? I'll have PA, which is the available power, is equal to half B squared. So if you substitute this condition, I'll get 1 minus gamma in squared, because I can write this, I mean, let's write it in terms of gamma s squared whole squared. Am I right? Gamma in can be replaced with gamma s star. Gamma in will be replaced with gamma s star. So gamma s into gamma s star will be gamma s squared. I also have a squared term here, so it's written here. So this is available here, and this can also be written as 1 minus modulus of gamma s squared. So what happens? This fellow and this fellow will cancel. So I'll have PA to be equal to half B s squared by 1 minus gamma s squared. 1 minus gamma s squared. So this is the available power at the amplifier. So we will stop here, and in the next class what we will do is we will continue, we will derive the amplifier gain, and you know, we have something called as unilateral gain, and we will tell you what will be the noise in the amplifier and all those things, noise figure of this amplifier. All those things we will continue in our next class.